Hey guys, PJ Bottoms is back again with the review of Peter Chimera's sixth story, and possibly his seventh or eighth. Actually, no, probably just the seventh, because this one's actually a little bit long. So, as you know, I've been reviewing his stories for the past few minutes, and for the past whatever or so. And let me tell you, his stories are pretty bad. I don't like them. Let's begin on the sixth story. It's a Devil May Cry fanfic called Devil May Cry, The Crying of the Demon. It's written by Peter Chimera, one of his 12 stories. It's rated T, it's English, it's horror, it's Dante, and it's 91 reviews. So, let's start. Dante waited here red in his castel of darkness, but he was not sad, was angry one. A man that was that a demon came to conquer him, but it would not be so. I have come to deliver a message. I hope he's going to type message, because if that's massage, that's weird. From a demon, sated a beard man with angry sword.
Oh my god! So the sword is angry? That's kind of like my fingernail clippers being angry at me, because I used them to clip my fingernails! Are you angry at me, huh? Are you angry at me?
How are you Anyway, he ripped Dante Castla, but Dante ducked under the sword and returned the fatal blow. Who the demon? Dante sets down his fist. I am only bring message, and the man died with blood attack. His blood attacked him? What, it just like form a rope and wrap around his neck and choke him to death? Hey, I don't know, I'm gonna prick myself and have my blood kill me. Alright. Dante was explorer for clues in old mansion. Time to rock and roll, his spotted head brightened with him. Relax your weapon, we open, said a demon woman. Her name, Hill, said, was Carvin, and she explosioned a fire at him. Dante took his pistols and cracked a awesome lightning, don't you mean an awesome lightning or whatever, and she came to exploding. Dante swooped down with his sword, but sword broke. Knack one. Tat was my feathers. I think he's trying to say either fathers or feathers. Sword, I murder you. But she was already merdredicted. I don't know what that word is. Because she was undead. Ghost. Undead is one word. Ghost spirit of demon working for the great Damon Master Powerloff. Good work, you owe Freed Kravne, but now fights you against me, and it was Simon Belmont from Castlevania who turns more evil by Darkula. I mean Dracula. Too much power, so Dante did not have his sword and had used his gun attack. Fire bullet, Dante shoot at Simon and blood his face off. No. Blood his face off. How do you blood someone's face off? Here, I'm going to take some blood out of my... I'm going to bleed a little, okay? Then I'm going to hit you with it and blood your face off. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to blood your face off there. Dude is a moron. Simon was not free, though, because he was under evil power to ignore. Dante felt bad about it, but Tata was his duty. He would make new sword out of metal and would win triumph over another evil again. He end. This is just horrible. Alright, I'm gonna go get a drink and be right back. Mr. J, entertain. Entertain him, Mr. J. Move, Mr. J. I'm back. Alright. Yes, I will be posting the link to that one in the description. Oh, let's go to the next one. I'm gonna have a headache by the end of this. Black Crisis with Master Chief. It's a Halo fanfic. It's rated T, it's English, it's sci-fi and adventure. It's Master Chief and John 117. And it has 65 reviews. Let's begin. Alright. Chief, not now, Master Chief answered as he blasted his rifle at the Covenant guys. I am in an emergency. When the emergency was over, he said to the radio, "What is the message?" "It is very important," said Private Martha Burke, "and you must return to base. I will drive you there." She pulled in on a warthog. A warthog! So they drive pigs in Halo? Wow, I never knew that. This sounds like such an interesting game. Just in time as more Covenant guys came running with other guns. Chief jumped into the back and fired the turret at full power. "What is it?" he said as he shot all over. "Hold on," Martha panicked. "Why does a warthog have a turret?" "We are driving right into a black hole." When Master Chief killed the last of the Covenant, he let go of the turret and picked up two rocket launchers. "It's action time," he said. I guess that's what he says sometimes. Then he pointed and fired the rockets at the black hole, but it did nothing. "Giant grates," he screamed. But it was too late and they got sucked in. His plan didn't work. "Our only plan is to use a teleport," she shouted, but couldn't be heard over the black hole. Minutes later, they were on the ship and everything was okay. "Thanks for saving us," Master Chief sighed, because it was such a long day. Well, at least this one had a plot and wasn't as bad, but still pretty bad. Yeah, I'll post a link to that one too. Remember, they're all in the description, which is right down there. See? Right where my finger's pointing. Right in the description down there. I don't have enough time for a third one. Alright, let's see this. Castlevania, Wisp of Dracula. Rated T, it's English, it's supernatural and suspense, it's Richard B. and Dracula, and it has 127 reviews. The Richter Belmont was read a letter he got from the mail. His son was sick, but he read the letter over the candle for the lights. It was dark night, and he was in the house, but the letter was W.S. from Maria Renard. Said was from away you, and we was worry of her. Alucard is feared that, oh my God, that we be trouble. I send the power up fro UO to combat the evil. Is Alucard, it must be Dracula backwards, that's the way I'm seeing it. So he takes the power and the light turned to all white around him till it was so bright his eyes couldn't see the vision. Richten gasped, "It is that powerful." 10 Dracula came and each of the animals all over the forest. Word spread to the village where T. Belmont family was warned of it. "It's dreadful. I am worried of my husband who lumbers in the forest all day." "Donut, worry. I am safe the village from him." And Richard said goodbye to Nebauer Shelley and ran off to fight the vampire. First he fogged the Frankenstein and deaf but whole bunch of skeletons too until he found Ted Dracula. "Ha ha," Dracula laughed for Ed. "You have fighting for a very long house." He was fighting for a very long house. "It is almost midnight and then I will be more powerful." "I can fight for a few hours." He's fighting for a few horse. "More," and he whipped the crystal out of Darkula's hand. "That is Loney crystal. That is not source of power. I am still power." So Ricketer whip again and Darkula neck blooded. Dracula, let me just state this. I don't like Twilight, but I've seen enough of it to know that vampires do not bleed. It's impossible. Because they're dead. Don't understand. That crystal was a fake. I sent it to you to replace the real one. It is full of holy water, which you are standing on, so you lose all your power. No, that does not make sense. That's what I say about the story. Whip again, he commanded as he whipped at the head off. Darkula's head rolled down to Forest Hill into the swamp by Transylvania Desert, and his body turned to dust. I will, ill, never fight Duo again, but my son will fight when he is older. That is cursed Ophé the Belmont. But he came home, and his son was dead of the skhick. No, it impossible. Richter was sadly, but he knew that he could train of other Belmont. He wolf, never have another child. My God. This is just horrible. This dude makes me sick. He makes me want to vomit. I can barely breathe now. Alright, guys, so that was the reviews of his 6th, 7th, and 8th stories. God, mercy on my soul. So, all the links are in the description, including the link to his profile, so you can review his fanfics himself and possibly send him an evil message. I have to stop for a while to gain my breath back so that I can breathe. So, I hope you all enjoy those. These reviews that I have up right now. Later.